Because of the manner in which you are presenting this to the court, both motions are denied. Got it?
So my client's being punished. Because I stand up for him and zealously represent my client's interests. And finding that, Judge, we're left hanging. Just tell the sheriff you can't investigate.
There's
not
an error. Judge, my name is
Sophia.
Judge, I was just trying to get a chance.
I'm going to do Judge, I was hopeful between now and then. Counsel told me to hold the court to investigate. I was hopeful that between now and then they would have completed their investigation and we would be ready to proceed with the eviction. I don't think that's the case.
Your Honor, we did, so in fact, we did investigate for the allegations made, which is what we were supposed to do, and we went through that. However, the big point of the motion to compel is that it's not prematurely. According to Councilman Holmes, this was only placed in the sheriff on August 26th. We're not even within our normal lag time to get to a bit. So the fact that we were investigating wouldn't have interfered with that.
First of all, Counsel, okay. In theory, he can bring that motion the following week after he places it. Okay? And your procedures do not dictate the enforceability. Okay? Now, are you still now, obviously, I accept the fact, the reality, okay, that your office has limited assets, limited human assets.
Correct.
To carry out your motion. Okay? So, this motion is technically timing. Okay? When did you place it in the sheriff's office, Counsel?
But the fact is, I was holding on hold for that
procedure. The point is, I think Councilman is going to say that we are refusing so that that is just not supported by any facts at all. We have never refused to do so. We have never stated that either orally or in writing whatsoever. So that is a false, entirely false, in fact, allegation.
So on a regular basis, when is the order going to be carried out?
Well, Judge, I'll address that. Thank you. Here's the thing, Judge. We're pretty close to finishing the investigation. We're within our normal parameters. We're going to do the eviction once the case gets clear. If there's an issue of it being clear, we have to take additional action. If we actually found an allegation, if it's true, then we would probably end up not doing any credit. At this point, what I've seen so far, we're close to closing the matter. I haven't seen anything, but I did get another email this morning from Mr. Gardner. So if it's true, then we would probably end up not doing any credit. At this point, what I've seen so far, we're close to closing the matter. I haven't seen anything, but I did get if it's true, then we would probably end up not doing any credit. At this point, what I've seen so far, we're close to closing the matter. I haven't seen anything, but I did get another email this morning from Mr. Gardner. So at this point, Judge, I think it's going to be a short time frame, another week, and we would know whether it was any basis as raised. And now we're getting to the point where we're either going to do the eviction very shortly, but we're not going to do the eviction based on. But I haven't seen anything.
So it is on hold.
And we're not refusing it. That means I'm not going to refuse it.
Well, here's the example. I want to make sure we understand.
Sure,
right? Right? This is actually a question. Okay. What does the sheriff's office have to investigate? And is the sheriff's office trying to do my job?
Well, Judge, first of all, in this year, the law enforcement agency, we're not trying to do your job.
What are you investigating?
We're investigating allegations, Judge, that Mr. Allegations
have all been. What does the sheriff's office have to investigate? And is the sheriff's office trying to do my job? What does the sheriff's office have to investigate? And is the sheriff's office trying to do my job?
Well, Judge, first of all, in this year, the law enforcement agency, we're not trying to do your job.
What are you investigating?
We're investigating allegations, Judge, that Mr. Nevel received certain court orders due to fraudulent activity, including perjury. That was in the letter that Mr. Galloway's held that Mr. Nevel received certain court orders due to fraudulent activity, including perjury. That was in the letter, Judge, that received certain court orders due to fraudulent activity, including perjury.
What are you investigating?
We're investigating allegations, Judge, that Mr. Galloway's held that Mr. Nevel received certain court orders due to fraudulent activity, including perjury. That was in the letter, Judge, that was sent to us from Mr. Garrett. And that's what we have to do.
Well, I would think that the question is whether or not that is actually a valid court order, counsel. And if you want to bring fraud allegations in this court, you have the opportunity to do so when you have standing, okay? If he doesn't have standing, are you going to let this woman who just walked in the courtroom make fraud allegations too? Because she doesn't have standing either. Standing, okay? If he doesn't have standing, are you going to let this woman who just walked in the courtroom make fraud allegations too? Because she doesn't have standing either.
I understand that, Judge Clark. The allegations were made, and the big takes of our office are that we have to look into it. And we're trying to do
well, it. Counsel, here. If you want to be bound by the dictates of your office as opposed to order of court, you do so at your peril.
That's fine, Judge. Okay. All we're saying, judges, we're within our normal lifetime, and we're taking a look at it. We have not ever refused.
If you want to be bound by the dictates of your office as opposed to order of court, you do so at your peril.
That's fine, Judge.
Okay.
All we're saying, judges, we're within our normal lifetime, and we're taking a look at it. We have not ever refused to execute that order, Judge, because within this time frame that Mr. Nevel claims we're refusing and saying it maliciously as if we have a disregard for the court.
Okay.
And again, the parameters of what he has to show for rule to show cause are non-existent. Because they're not willfully and promptly and maliciously wanting
here. I want to make sure you're all understanding, okay? If someone is making the allegations that there was fraud committed in the foreclosure court, that's the foreclosure judge's decision, okay? I have people in here all the time claiming that a foreclosure judge was misled by fraud. Take that up at the foreclosure court, okay? I am not going to second guess the ruling of a foreclosure judge. Second, I don't think the sheriff's office was fraud committed in the foreclosure court. That's the foreclosure judge's decision, okay? I have people in here all the time claiming that a foreclosure judge was misled by fraud. Take that up at the foreclosure court, okay? I am not going to second guess the ruling of a foreclosure judge. Second, I don't think the sheriff's office should be second guessing the decision of this court. If someone else wants to make those allegations, let them make the allegations. If they have standing, I will hear them, okay? Now, Mr. Nevel,
Your Honor. August 26th.
Okay. Your motion for rule to show cause, Judge Greenberg, is being denied without prejudice. Okay? I do think it is not yet timely for me to be issuing a rule to show cause against the sheriff.
And then turn order to file. This order needs to be executed. They do not have the authority to launch your order and say, it's on hold while we second guess you. And that's what they're doing. This order needs to be executed. They do not have the authority to launch your order and say, it's on hold while we second guess you. And that's what they're doing. And then turn order to file. This order needs to be executed. They do not have the authority to launch your order and say, it's on hold while we second guess you. And that's what they're doing by this whole
okay. I am not going to allow lawyers to come in here. What did you say the name was Chris? I am not going to allow lawyers to come in here. What did you say the name was Chris?
August 26th. And, I checked the next week to see if it's been scheduled.
Okay, counsel.
It's been on hold.
Okay,
and I
no. You rephrase that no. Motion to adjourn. Thank you.
I'm sorry, I was here on the matter of cats versus Brown. This guy is court denied.
Well, I'm going to call you, Mr.
Nevel. Your Honor. Here. Look,
denied.
Court denied.
Well, I'm going to call you, Mr. Mr. Nevel, Your Honor, here, look,
deny you
to
be,
Mr. Nevel, Your Honor, here, look,
deny you to be what they don't have to do.
Okay. So then what? You want to misrepresent my rules, you go right into counsel, you do it so it's your error.
Then what is your ruling? They're saying that I have been told they will not execute this order, so they decide to. That's your ruling. They don't have to. You're not going to compel them. You're not going to even say, when are you going to finish your investigation? It's just open-ended. Then what is your ruling? They're saying that I have been told they will not execute this order, so they decide to. That's your ruling. They don't have to. You're not going to compel them. You're not going to even say, when are you going to finish your investigation? It's just open-ended. Because I get some clownish complaints saying that I've been brought at the court, that there's a church out there that we shouldn't do anything. Where's my relief, Judge? Yes, you're right. Because I get some clownish complaints saying that I've been brought at the court. Because I get some clownish complaints saying that I've been brought at the court, that there's a church out there that we shouldn't do anything. Where's my relief, Judge? Yes, you're right.
Okay.
It's not a final order.
I think you're being very disrespectful.
I don't mean to be, but Your Honor has left me hanging.
I think you're being very disrespectful.
I don't mean to be, but Your Honor has left
me hanging. I think you're being very disrespectful.
I don't mean to be, but Your Honor.
I think you're being very disrespectful.
I don't mean to be, but Your Honor has left me hanging. What am I supposed to do? Your Honor has left me hanging. What am I supposed to do? I don't mean to be, but Your Honor has left me hanging. What am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do?
No, I have not.
It's not a final order.
I think you're being very disrespectful.
I don't mean to be, but Your Honor has left me hanging. What am I supposed to do? Left me hanging. What am I supposed to do? Left me hanging. What am I supposed to do? Left me hanging. What am I supposed to do?
No, I have not left you hanging,
counsel. Here's what I'm specifically ruling.
I have not left you hanging, counsel.
Here's what I'm specifically ruling, okay? There are probably thousands.
What am I supposed to do?
No, I have not left your hands, counsel.
Here's what I'm
saying. What am I supposed to do?
No, I have not left your hands, counsel. No, I have not left your hands, counsel.
Here's what I'm specifically ruling, okay? There are probably thousands. Let me think this through. Probably there's 1,000 orders that I have entered in the past month. They haven't been carried out yet. Okay? If I start issuing rules to show cause on every one of those, it's simply not feasible, counsel. I think it is premature. Now, the way I understand this is a very unusual case. No two ways about it. Okay? The specific remedy that you are asking for today is inappropriate. I'm not saying things might change in a week. No, it's the
motion from hell as well. Your Honor can enter the order and say, Mr. Sheriff, you don't even have the authority to put this on hold.
No, because here's what I'm doing.
Say, help as well. Your Honor can enter the order and say, Mr. Sheriff, you don't even have the authority to put this on hold.
No, because here's what I'm doing.
Help. Your Honor can enter the order and say, Mr. Sheriff, you don't even have the authority to put this on hold.
No, because here's what I'm doing. Because of the manner in which you are presenting this to the court, full motions are denied.
Got it?
Motions are denied. Got it? Which you are presenting this to the court, full motions are denied.
Got it?
Because of the manner in which you are presenting this to the court, full motions are denied.
Got it? So my client's being punished. Because I stand up for him and zealously